Julian.
Hi.
Welcome to StarTest, the computer interview. Please just relax and enjoy yourself.
I'm Julian Cope. I'm a singer. I'm 31. That's about it.
Here are 9 categories of questions. Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Faith and fortune.
Faith and fortune.
Number one.
Have you ever been to a fortune teller?
No, I don't want to know. Well, actually, that's not really the case, because I had a real weird thing happen when I was 19. I was at a party with Mac from Echo and the Burning Man, who was 18, and Dave Pickett, who was our old drummer, who was 18. And this woman said that, she told our fortunes, and she said that Dave Pickett would try and he wouldn't do much, and then Mac would do well and he'd die before he was 30, but he would be well loved. And then she said that I would be really successful in my mid-30s and be hated by everybody. So until the day before yesterday, I was completely shitting it, because unfortunately Mac was coming up to 30 and I haven't seen him for ages, and if anything would have happened to him, I would have felt really bad. And it was his birthday the other day, so Donald, my guitarist, sprung up and said, "Yes, Mac's made it to 30, so happy birthday, Mac, and I'm off the hook, and I won't be a bastard when I'm in my mid-30s. And before."
Do you enjoy gambling?
Sometimes, not with money or anything like that. I used to like ridiculous bets. Like, I used to bet older kids at school. You know, you used to have those family tables where the older guy would be a monitor. He'd be the pudding monitor. And he'd be there and he'd be like, "You're not having any because you're smaller than me and I'll beat you up." And I used to bet £1 million that I could climb inside this water jug and be peeping out from right inside. And he'd never bet me £1 million. So I always thought, good psychology. Number 5.
How cynical are you?
Not cynical. No. Number 6.
Name 3 great things about being you.
Waking up in the morning and seeing Dorian, who's my wife, who's just completely cool. That's just the best, that she really slays me. And being able to write about hang-ups and all the garbage that's in your head, just write and somebody says, "Yeah, let's put that on a record, that's really good." And another thing that's good is I've got loads of toys. So I mean, just on a completely selfish level, those are 3 good things. Number 15.
What is your vision of hell?
A loop tape of you too. Number 14.
If you met God, what would you ask her?
If she thought we were doing well, because I think we're doing quite well considering nobody told us anything.
Now please select a new category.
Sweet and sour.
Sweet and sour.
Number 8.
How far do you really like yourself?
I don't know. I like myself in interviews now. I like myself musically. But I don't know if I completely like myself. 13.
Who is your best friend?
My wife, Dorian. wanted such a break. You know? I just think this is the best break that anybody could give anybody. And I kind of, I feel that with all the people who are in such a bad place, a bad position in the world, you know, then I've got to be good at being what I am. Because it's like say life, as an analogy, say life is like a play or something. I'm standing at the front, so I've got, somebody's given me really good tickets, so it's my duty to enjoy the play, man, because it's rude of me not to, because there's all these people starving around the world. They're the people who've got a really, really bad break, and they're standing at the back, and they're all smaller than everybody else, and they can't see over, so they never even get to see what life is. They never even got to see the stars, you know? People just say, you know, work and you've got a chance, and that's complete garbage. It's just rudeness. There's so much rudeness. So much rudeness in our society as well, which really kind of gets to me. Some people, they just physically can't get it together, they can't mentally get it together, you know. I'll apologize for them if it makes kind of, you know, people in power feel any better. Sometimes you can't get out of a room. Sometimes the world just completely bewilders you and does your head in, you know. And going out is the same as being dragged and knocked senseless by a bunch of muggers, and that's just sometimes the way that it is.
Who is your favorite film director?
I don't know. Whoever directed Back to the Future, or maybe Steven Spielberg.
Which is your favorite drink?
Diet Lilt.
Who is your favorite actress?
Used to be Helen Mirren.
What car do you drive?
Can't drive.
Which is your favorite club?
I never go to clubs.
When did you last cut your toenails?
About 2 weeks ago.
Were you breastfed?
Yes, for far too long.
Which is your favorite city?
London.
Do you prefer apples or bananas?
Bananas.
Who is your favorite cartoon character?
Bugs Bunny. Slag off can really kind of like erupt you inside, and you can be full of crap a lot of the time. I think it's, you need to have somebody kicking around inside you, you know. If there's no friction in what you do, then there's no way that you're gonna get on, you know. Best way to make great art is to have it trivialized by other people as much as possible. That way you fight and fight and fight. I'm fired.
What brings out the worst in you?
My brother coming around. Because as soon as my brother comes around, I start acting like my father. And like, My brother's very untogether, so he won't know how to get home. So I'll start giving him maps and all kinds of bullshit, and saying, look, if I were you, I'd go this way, and then I just go like that. And it really pisses me off, because there's nothing wrong with being like your father occasionally. Just occasionally that's bound to come out. It's not that my father's a really good guy, but I'd rather not be like that. Number four.
What do you most fear?
Burning to death. Number eight.
What goes through your mind while you're on stage?
All kinds of stuff. I love the front row to be young, like women or young guys who are good looking, because you want the front row to be good looking, because you need, my eyes are so bad that I need to be able to see what the audience looks like. If the front row looks good, then I can feel like I'm getting it on with the whole audience. But sometimes people just have to say one thing, the wrong thing. Not even a wind-up, they can be really kind of trying to be cool. That'll really get to me. And I won't be too professional, eh? Number 10.
Reveal a secret about yourself.
Hold on, I have to think about that one. Whether... don't know if I should really say anything, you know? I got VD when I was 14. And that freaked everybody out. But me especially, because I got a stupid moralizing doctor telling me that it was wrong, when I knew that it was wrong in any case, because it messed me up so much. And that was kind of the worst heavy time. That's the secret. 13.
How much do you like looking at yourself in the mirror?
Sometimes loads, and sometimes I think, what a totally old dude. Number one.
Which animal best describes your personality? Your personality.
It's dead obvious, but it's the turtle. That may be proved in the end.
Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Love and passion.
Love and passion.
Number one.
What are your passions?
Music, my wife, women, toys, that's it. Number two.
Would you like to have an affair with yourself?
I'd like to swap over to see what it was like to have sex with me. But then again, I'd like to find out what it was like to be a woman. Having sex with a man in any case. I guess a lot of people think that. Number three.
How did you feel when you last fell in love?
Like a garbage truck had run over me. Number five.
Are you romantic?
Yes. Number seven.
How would you describe the perfect relationship?
A relationship where you want to do something for somebody so badly that it's not a problem, that something's missing when they're not actually there, like you physically aren't complete. Also, a perfect relationship would include not feeling resentful that that person makes you feel so great. Nine.
What are your inhibitions?
I don't know. I don't know if I have any particular ones. I think there's just too many to even talk about. Number 8.
What is your most wicked fantasy?
My most wicked fantasy? My evil fantasy? Well, if it's a fantasy, maybe my most evil fantasy is that the white race doesn't actually belong here and was put here to mess everybody up. And everything that I do as like a total kind of wasp that I am is going to destroy the rest of the world with its half-assed evangelical calling. But I don't even know if that's a fantasy, see, because I kind of believe that. Number 12.
Now please select a new category.
Power and the glory.
Power and glory.
8.
Who holds most power over you?
Me. 7.
Who do you envy?
I don't know, just people with a simple life, you know, people who don't have to go around and mess themselves up all the time. That kind of I really envy. People who put on TV and really enjoy enjoy Neighbours. And people who go into, like, I don't know, Next or something and go, oh, wow, brilliant shirt, this is totally cool. And then, like, the radio comes on and they go, this is so good, this is so good. Steve Wright is fantastic, wow. I just think that I am envious of that, even though it sounds like I'm not really envious. I am envious of that, because sometimes it's a real drag, you know. Sometimes you do feel like you only like one side of a Miles Davis album. Even that sounds like garbage. Number 15.
How much do you owe your fans?
I don't owe them anything, man, really. They get what's coming. And they always like it 6 months later in any case, because I always mean it. So even if I make records that are rubbish, at least they know I mean it, because it would be such a drag to be into somebody and find out that it was all complete and utter fabrication, you know? There must be many a Jam fan who doesn't feel too good. Number 6.
Who would you stand next to in the Hall of Fame?
Between Chris de Burg and Chris Rea. And Patel.
Do you secretly believe that you are, some way or other, better than other people?
Not better. No, that's real crap to say better. Don't even think I'm worse. You know, it's like having admiration for putting up the Empire State Building, which I have deep admiration for people who can do things I can't do. It's kind of a shame in a way, because like pop music or rock and roll or whatever you call it is all made by a bunch of rank amateurs, all pretending that they know the rules, and that's what's exciting about it, really. You know, so as soon as they start going on an art trip, it's real garbage. No, there's no such thing as better or worse. The guy who knows the least is probably the one who's got the most chance of getting where he wants to be.
Please concentrate hard on answering the questions in this section truthfully. If you appear not to be telling the whole truth, you will forfeit the chance to show your video.
It doesn't matter.
From the 5 questions which follow, you may pass on just 2. How good were the Teardrop Explodes?
Mainly crap, actually.
idea was the front cover of Fried?
Mine.
Is it fair to call your songs self-obsessive?
Yeah. Yes, it's fair because that's what I'm obsessed about. You know? It's probably a real kind of bourgeois trip. But that's the way that it is, and while I'm allowed to do it, it's what I'll write about, because that way I'll find out.
You now have 30 seconds to plug your latest video. Please start now.
I've done this video, right, like Fraser did it, and he's my mate. And he worked really hard. Peter Freitas from Mecca and the Bunny Man's doing the drums. He's in it, me mate Andy. It's called China Doll, and there's a chick in it as well.
Foolish child, shade your eyes, blanket the sun. Came the day I'm safe. Magic carpet ride, dreams and all true. See my alabaster child roll on, 'cause I'm an earthbound boy, and so I worship you, China doll.
Thank you for playing Star Test.
You're welcome.
What question are you glad you weren't asked?
There's so many millions of questions that I'm glad I wasn't asked, that I'd be foolish to say, because then a journalist would see it and ask me, and they ask those kind of questions, whereas you can't answer, so I can fake it.
To select five characteristics from the on-screen menu which you feel best illustrate your personality.
Happy, pessimistic, imaginative, open, and sad.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
On your TV.
Julian.
Hi.
Welcome to Star Test, the computer interview. Please just relax and enjoy yourself.
I'm Julian Cope. I'm a singer. I'm 31. That's about it.
Here are nine categories of questions. Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Faith and fortune.
faith and fortune.
Number one.
Have you ever been to a fortune teller?
No, I don't want to know. Well, actually, that's not really the case, because I had a real weird thing happen when I was 19. I was at a party with Mac from Echo and the Bunnymen, who was 18, and Dave Pickett, who was our old drummer, who was 18. And this woman said that, she told our fortunes, and she said that Dave Pickett would try and he wouldn't do much, and then Mac would do well and he'd die before he was 30, but he would be well loved. And then she said that I would be really successful in my mid-30s and be hated by everybody. So until the day before yesterday, I was completely shitting it, because unfortunately Mac was coming up to 30 and I hadn't seen him for ages, and if anything would have happened to him, I would have felt really bad. And it was his birthday the other day, so Donald, my guitarist, sprung up and said, "Yes, Mac's made it to 30, so happy birthday, Mac, and I'm off the hook, and I won't be a bastard when I'm in my mid-30s. And before."
Do you enjoy gambling?
Sometimes, not with money or anything like that. I used to like ridiculous bets. Like, I used to bet older kids at school. You know, you used to have those family tables where the older guy would be a monitor. He'd be the pudding monitor, and he'd be there, and he'd be like, "You're not having any because you're smaller than me, and I'll beat you up." And I used to bet £1 million that I could climb inside this water jug and be peeping out from right inside. And he'd never bet me £1 million, so I always thought, good psychology. Number five.
How cynical are you?
Not cynical. No. Number six.
Name three great things about being you.
Waking up in the morning and seeing Dorian, who's my wife, who's just completely cool. That's just the best. That she really slays me. And being able to write about hang-ups and all the garbage that's in your head, just write and somebody says, "Yeah, let's put that on a record, that's really good." And another thing that's good is I've got loads of toys. So I mean, just on a completely selfish level, those are three good things. Number 15.
What is your vision of hell?
A loop tape of you too. Number 14.
If you met God, what would you ask her?
If she thought we were doing well, because I think we're doing quite well considering nobody told us anything.
Now please select a new category.
Sweet and sour.
Sweet and sour.
Number eight.
How far do you really like yourself?
I don't know. I like myself in interviews now. I like myself musically. But I don't know if I completely like myself. I'm 13.
Who is your best friend?
My wife. Dorian. Dorian and Julian. Number 10.
What's the best reason for being alive?
Just because it's such a break. You know? I just think this is the best break that anybody could give anybody. And I kind of, I feel that with all the people who are in such a bad place, a bad position in the world, you know, then I've got to be good at being what I am. Because it's like say life, as an analogy, say life is like a play or something. I'm standing at the front, so I've got somebody's given me really good tickets, so it's my duty to enjoy the play, man, because it's rude of me not to, because there's all these people starving around the world. They're the people who've got a really, really bad break, and they're standing at the back, and they're all smaller than everybody else, and they can't see over, so they never even get to see what life is. They never even got to see the stars, you know? People just say, you know, work and you've got a chance, and that's complete garbage. It's just rudeness. There's so much rudeness. So much rudeness in our society as well, which really kind of gets to me. Some people, they just physically can't get it together, they can't mentally get it together, you know. I'll apologize for them if it makes kind of, you know, people in power feel any better. Sometimes you can't get out of a room. Sometimes the world just completely bewilders you and does your head in, you know? And going out is the same as being dragged and knocked senseless by a bunch of muggers, and that's just sometimes the way that it is.
Who is your favorite film director?
I don't know. Whoever directed Back to the Future, or maybe Steven Spielberg.
Which is your favorite drink?
Diet Lilt.
Who is your favorite actress?
Used to be Helen Mirren.
What car do you drive?
Can't drive.
Which is your favorite club?
I never go to clubs.
When did you last cut your toenails?
About 2 weeks ago.
Were you breastfed?
Yes, for far too long.
Which is your favorite city?
London.
Do you prefer apples or bananas?
Bananas.
Who is your favorite cartoon character?
Bugs Bunny. Slag off can really kind of like erupt you inside, and you can be full of crap a lot of the time. I think it's, you need to have somebody kicking around inside you, you know. If there's no friction in what you do, then there's no way that you're gonna get on, you know. Best way to make great art is to have it trivialized by other people as much as possible. That way you fight and fight and fight. And fire.
What brings out the worst in you?
My brother coming around. Because as soon as my brother comes around, I start acting like my father. And like, my brother's very untogether, so he won't know how to get home, so I'll start giving him maps and all kinds of bullshit, and saying, look, if I were you, I'd go this way, and then I just go like that, and it really pisses me off, because there's nothing wrong with being like your father occasionally. Just occasionally, that's bound to come out. It's not that my father's a really good guy, but I'd rather not be like that. Number four.
What do you most fear?
Burning to death. Number eight.
What goes through your mind while you're on stage?
all kinds of stuff. I love the front row to be young, like women or young guys who are good looking, because you want the front row to be good looking, because you need, my eyes are so bad that I need to be able to see what the audience looks like. If the front row looks good, then I can feel like I'm getting it on with the whole audience. But sometimes people just have to say one thing, the wrong thing. Not even a wind-up, they can be really kind of trying to be cool. That'll really get to me. And I won't be too professional, eh? Number 10.
Reveal a secret about yourself.
Hold on, I have to think about that one. Whether... don't know if I should really say anything, you know? I got VD when I was 14. And that freaked everybody out. But me especially, because I got a stupid moralizing doctor telling me that it was wrong, when I knew that it was wrong in any case, because it messed me up so much. And that was kind of the worst heavy time. That's the secret. 13.
How much do you like looking at yourself in the mirror?
Sometimes loads, and sometimes I think, what a totally old dude. Number one.
Which animal best describes your personality? Your personality.
It's dead obvious, but it's the turtle. That may be proved in the end.
Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Love and passion.
Love and passion.
Number one.
What are your passions?
Music. My wife. Women. Toys. That's it. Number two.
Would you like to have an affair with yourself?
I'd like to swap over to see what it was like to have sex with me. But then again, I'd like to find out what it was like to be a woman. Having sex with a man in any case. I guess a lot of people think that. Number three.
How did you feel when you last fell in love?
Like a garbage truck had run over me. Number five.
Are you romantic?
Yes. Number seven.
How would you describe the perfect relationship?
A relationship where you want to do something for somebody so badly that it's not a problem, that something's missing when they're not actually there, like you physically aren't complete. Also, a perfect relationship would include not feeling resentful that that person makes you feel so great. Nine.
What are your inhibitions?
I don't know. I don't know if I have any particular ones. I think there's just too many to even talk about. Number eight.
What is your most wicked fantasy?
My most wicked fantasy? My evil fantasy? Well, if it's a fantasy, maybe my most evil fantasy is that the white race doesn't actually belong here and was put here to mess everybody up. And everything that I do as like a total kind of wasp that I am, is going to destroy the rest of the world with its half-assed evangelical calling. But I don't even know if that's a fantasy, see, because I kind of believe that. Number 12.
Now please select a new category.
Power and the glory.
Power and glory.
8.
Who holds most power over you?
Me. 7.
Who do you envy?
I don't know, just people with a simple life, you know, people who don't have to go around and mess themselves up all the time. That kind of I really envy. People who put on TV and really enjoy enjoy Neighbours. And people who go into, like, I don't know, Next or something and go, oh, wow, brilliant shirt, this is totally cool. And then, like, the radio comes on and they go, this is so good. This is so good. Steve Wright is fantastic. Wow. I just think that I am envious of that, even though it sounds like I'm not really envious. I am envious of that, because sometimes it's a real drag, you know. Sometimes you do feel like you only like one side of a Miles Davis album. Even that sounds like garbage. Number 15.
How much do you owe your fans?
I don't owe them anything, man, really. They get what's coming. And they always like it 6 months later in any case, because I always mean it. So even if I make records that are rubbish, at least they know I mean it, because it would be such a drag to be into somebody and find out that it was all complete and utter fabrication, you know? There must be many a Jam fan who doesn't feel too good. Number 6.
Who would you stand next to in the Hall of Fame?
Between Christa Berg and Chris Rea. Number 10.
Do you secretly believe that you are, in some way or other, better than other people?
Not better. No, that's real crap to say better. Don't even think I'm worse. You know, it's like having admiration for putting up the Empire State Building, which I have deep admiration for people who can do things I can't do. It's kind of a shame in a way, because like pop music or rock and roll or whatever you call it is all made by a bunch of rank amateurs, all pretending that they know the rules, and that's what's exciting about it, really. You know, so as soon as they start going on an art trip, it's real garbage. No, there's no such thing as better or worse. The guy who knows the least is probably the one who's got the most chance of getting where he wants to be.
Please concentrate hard on answering the questions in this section truthfully. If you appear not to be telling the whole truth, you will forfeit the chance to show your video.
It doesn't matter.
From the 5 questions which follow, you may pass on just 2. How good were the Teardrop Explodes?
Mainly crap, actually.
Whose idea was the front cover of Fried?
Mine.
Is it fair to call your songs self-obsessive?
Yeah. Yes, it's fair, because that's what I'm obsessed about, you know? Probably a real kind of bourgeois trip. But that's the way that it is, and while I'm allowed to do it, it's what I'll write about, because that way I'll find out.
now have 30 seconds to plug your latest video. Please start now.
I've done this video, right, like Fraser did it, and he's my mate. And he worked really hard. Peter Freitas from Mecca and the Bunnymen's doing the drums. He's in it, me mate Andy. It's called China Doll. And there's a chick in it as well.
Foolish child, shade your eyes, blanket the sun. Came the day I'm safe, you are the one. A magic carpet ride, dreams and all true. See my alabaster child.
Question, are you glad you weren't asked?
There's so many millions of questions that I'm glad I wasn't asked, that I'd be foolish to say, because then a journalist would see it and ask me, and they ask those kind of questions, whereas you can't answer, so I can fake it.
You are now invited to select five characteristics from the on-screen menu which you feel best illustrate your personality.
Happy, pessimistic, imaginative, open, and sad.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
On your TV. Despite the snow, we are still here. We're performing live. And despite the snow, Julian Cope has managed to join us with his